You know, ideas, we all know this. Ideas are far more important than technology or anything else. Always have been. Always have been. You can be ill-equipped, but if you're well-led and led with intelligence, you're going to be far better off.
There were a number of initiatives that General DePue, General Gorman, General Richardson, General Vano, other Army leaders pushed to the front in that period. There was a great change in our training doctrine, a great improvement in how we trained. There was a general sharpening up of the schools. There was the developing notion that there should be a second year program, which came to be the School of Advanced Military Studies, and there were the doctrinal shifts.
Everywhere we turned to the tactical and operational and strategic organizations, there was a SAMS planner who understood intuitively what we were after in terms of ends, ways, and means, and that made an enormous difference, I think, in the quality of that operation.
Because SAMS graduates walk into positions, walk into a plans shop, expecting to already be able to do these, solve really tough problems, right away gave me the ability to influence decision makers. The opportunity to go to a division, to go to a Corps headquarters, and immediately have an impact. So it doesn't matter who you are, when you arrive and you're a planner and you go into that, normally it's a room with no windows, and you go into that room and you're given all the things that are too hard to figure out within a 24-hour period, and you come out with some viable, feasible solutions. That opens a lot of doors, and normally you have direct access to the commanding general or the COCOM commander, as the case may be. That immediate feeling like you're value added and the opportunity to influence decision makers, I think, is a huge benefit in being a valued part of the team.
Hit them with a fist and a flanking movement and drove through them. And we were given operational control of the 1st Cavalry Division, and we had planned an envelopment with the 1st Cavalry Division around from the north and the Big Red One from the south. We had not only recent graduates who were planners, but we had those who had gone on and had become commanders. Their contributions were absolutely vital to the success, the battlefield success, and the mission success.
There's something different about the SAMS graduate and the way that the graduates look at problems, the types of solution sets that they come up with, the advice that they give, the depth of their knowledge. And this is very useful for commanders to receive the benefit of. It helps them to go to a different level themselves. At least I've certainly found that as a brigade commander with SAMS graduates, as a division commander with SAMS graduates, as a deputy commander at Corps, and now as an Army commander.
We are timeless students. We have to remain ready to learn something and change our minds about things as situation evolves. Allows us to tackle more difficult problems or problems who don't have a solution necessarily. And then finally, the ability to operate in chaos and uncertainty, to make a difficult situation progress through uncertainty, I think it's a definitely an ability that we learn through the SAMS program.
The quality of officer that goes in the SAMS program is clearly a notch ahead of the pack. Then on top of that, we expose them to just an exceptional faculty, the best the Army has to offer. We've got time-proven, cross-culturally demonstrated a methodology of learning the art and science of warfare. And then we put them in a laboratory to study and analyze warfare and to practice their craft. So at the end of this, you've got a person that is probably the best that we can offer at grade in terms of understanding our trade. When you need something done right and it's important and it involves war fighting, you look to have a SAMS graduate that's part of the staff. And most often they emerge as the leader of that staff to organize the information and the process.
So my most recent experience in Operation Inherent Resolve, I was one of 22 SAMS planners, from the commanding general, General McFarland, down to very recent graduates. And therefore my ability, having gone through SAMS, to understand and having shared similar experiences, having read similar books, just enabled us to build a better sum of parts in what was a pretty difficult period of creative thinking to be able to work through the problems that we faced. It's a very established brand now, and it's an established brand internationally. So, you know, in the UK, we know what SAMS graduates are. It's a known commodity. And what you get now is someone who we know has a sound basics of reading the true underlying theory of war, but has also been taught to run through the science, but also has the freedom of intellect to think laterally around problems. The extra year of school will deepen your education, it'll broaden your mind, it'll give you a whole new series of tools that you'll be able to take to the field, and it will make you a better leader, and it will make you a better staff officer.
Well, I think the SAMS education was very beneficial to me, because it was one of the things that has really inspired me to continue to grow and learn. And no matter how much you know, there's more you can learn and more you can know about what you're doing. And that's really critical in today's environment, which is very, very complex. And just that desire to continue to grow and learn and become more knowledgeable about what you're doing is important no matter where you are.
Really, the purpose of SAMS is leadership development, and SAMS does exactly that. They develop future leaders for the Army, for our sister services, as well as allies in other international armies.
What this gave me was a set of principles from which I could choose and then apply to whatever problem I had. If I could use a golfing analogy, when I go golfing, I don't take one club. And what SAMS gave me is many intellectual clubs from which I could choose to solve the problems that no one could have anticipated that I or anyone else would have faced.
Well, warfighting is an intense, lethal human endeavor that requires leaders of great character, unwavering commitment, and superior competence. And to win in this endeavor requires the intellectual to always lead the physical. If not, blood and treasure are wasted, trust is lost with the American people, and our national will erodes. SAMS graduates thrive in this ambiguity, and they bring order to chaos through critical and creative thinking. They help commanders frame and solve wicked and ill-structured problems that permeate every aspect of combat. That's what they're for, and that's what their commanders expect. And they've clearly demonstrated that they're ready after they've completed the SAMS course.